I think that's it's the timing to start. My name is Christos Leonis. I feel very privileged to be invited and chairing this session. We just a main aim is to discuss the certain issues already have been raised from the previous session. I think that the concept, as already have asked, a motivation. It was around a group outside that was discussing what means motivational system and what the role of motivation in smoking cessation. The concept of multidisciplinarity and interdisciplinarity, that means the team-based approach in the smoking cessation, and also the concept of risk management and harm reduction, included among the major hot topics that this session aims to discuss. I think already this slide highlight the key concepts that the session intends to discuss, especially giving particularly attention and a focus on primary and public health team, the team-based approach, either and the interprofessional collaboration, the understanding of the concept of multimorbidity and comorbidity, especially as a concept based on the theory already raised by Barbara Starfield from U.S. Johns Hopkins Hospital years ago. I think that's also among the main focus of that session. And also the implementation of educational, interventional approach and programs aiming to the behavior change also is among the issues. I'm not a speaker at the moment, but in generally, as you remember, Dr. Papadaki, an issue that many times when implementing a behavior change program focusing on smoking cessation on Crete, many practitioners, they asking us, what about smoking cessation and a group of people with mental disorders? And unfortunately, Greece has been affected by economic and not only crisis, and that's mental disorders are very, very common. And that's we needed in clarifying a strategy to what extent the educational or interventional programs, either on group, on groups or individuals, are effective, especially on people with the mental disorders. This slide is paying attention especially on patients with severe mental problems, mostly included people with schizophrenia and bipolar depression, that consist an important group of interventional programs. For many, many reasons, because that this type of people are in a very high risk for cardiovascular disease, and also are very obese, but also are very high smokers. And that all of those very introductory slides were coming and giving and asking all the important speakers that we have in the panel in a little bit dedicated at least 1 or 2 minutes, giving a focus on people with the mental disorders and especially with the severe mental disorders. And I'm certain that much discussion is needed to two very big thinkers, William Miller and Stefan Rolick. It was the people, they construct the so-called motivational interview, which just is mostly a conversation style in strengthening the person's decision to change motivation. At the moment, just 2 years ago, Rolling together with the other people was constructing and expanding and enhancing the motivational theory, motivational interviewing, especially applicable as a language, as conversation at schools, that already there are a lot of discussion how to implement motivational interviewing, especially for smoking cessation in change in adolescents, especially on the time they smoking is establishing. I think that was some very introductory slides in giving the importance and the focus of this session. And for me, it's a great pleasure in introducing Dr. Sofia Papadakis, which is an associate professor.